What's good, YouTube family?
Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. Now, Tony is in a situation with Gilly the Kid right now. You know what I mean? I got some receipts I wanted to play. In case y'all don't know what's happening, Gilly the Kid, former partner, shout out to OFF Dolph for playing. I'm about to play something for y'all right quick before I get started. Hold on, man.
Funnel set up from your ass team. These is all my people.
But we gonna talk about this shit today. We gonna start off right with the fat shit. Cause I like talking about fat motherfuckers that try to flex. Yep. Y'all know I'm ready. So, y'all see me just post this Him 500 interview on $1 million worth of game. So, you wanna talk about... I was loyal a while on Gilly. Gilly birthday coming up. What happened last year, man? I took Gilly to motherfucking Mexico, $40,000 right, for his birthday, showing love because the nigga had helped me blow up my platform. I show love to real niggas. Niggas be talking this real.
Okay, that's Tony part. We'll play Him 500 later. I just want to get started with this video right quick, man. Look, it seems it's the norm to criticize somebody. When somebody who put who on, who didn't help who, it's the most easiest beef to always get into. So you gotta be fair making this video, gang. Like, I ain't gonna even lie to y'all. I'm gonna be so fair making this video because everybody who's involved in it, I don't wanna look like I'm picking a side. Now, you got Tony. Let me verify what date he actually said it so y'all can know. All right, man, I seen the date. Tony the Closer, he's been on the platform, $1 million worth of game, for a while now. He came on there when Dev got kicked off or left, however that situation went. Now, when Tony came, hey Tony, this is to you first of all. Before I get on Gilly and Wallow, Tony, every time you was on the show, brother, whether you helped Gilly and Wallow or not, this is an entertainment business. I even took losses because I wanted to take time out. You see the crib I got behind me, and I was doing personal things for over a month. My views took a hit. This is an entertainment business, gang. You can't hop on here being the quiet man and thinking you're gonna win. Every time I seen you on the show, I seen a well-reserved, cool brother, but that well-reserved, cool brother doesn't last too long if every single episode you're well and reserved, cool brother. You know what I mean, Tony? You're always on the shows, you don't speak much, you don't interject your opinion when it's time to, and a lot of the things may be because you watch what happened to Dev. You watch that Gilly the Kid and Wallow, although they may not be vocal or aggressive, but their behaviors behind the scene is very vocal and aggressive. Meaning that they ain't dealing with no BS, they kicking folks out if folks is playing with them, which is understandable. But with you, you're speaking on this thing, bro. You the money man. You doing all this for Gilly, bro. You saying a whole lot on this thing, bro. And I had to sit back and look at, okay, now Gilly and them. I'm gonna be fair, Gilly. This is the second main person of influence, somewhat of influence. I ain't gonna cap on Tony the Closer like that. You know what I mean? I know Tony the Closer, he used to be in the NFL. Things didn't go too good. He's been through a whole lot. He's like a doormat for some people. His girl cheated on him. He told that story and how he got played and used, and a lot of other people playing and abused him. So he's a vulnerable character, and it's easy for folks to take advantage of him. Not saying Gilly and Wallow took advantage of him, because Tony then stated on that rant that Wallow continues to call him. Well, you say that, bro. You said a nigga still calls you. He hit up your phone, and all of a sudden, niggas ain't answering phone calls now. You say you got text messages and receipts, so let's fast forward to what I'm trying to say. Gilly the Kid and Wallow, but mostly Gilly the Kid. It seems that his nature, his demeanor, he's easy to get attacked. I tried to listen to Tony video and go on a full throttle and be like, damn, Dev was right about Gilly the Kid, or Wallow is fake, Wallow ain't real. But then you gotta pay attention to what a motherfucker is telling you. You get what I'm saying? You gotta listen to what a motherfucker is telling you. This man, Tony, started breaking the situation down more thoroughly, and he talked about how the police whooped his ass. You know what I mean? He's on the ground. He even specified how he was on the ground. I even got a Wallow hat. I'm on the ground. If you watch the video, I got a Wallow hat. That made me know everything I needed to know, because it's more the feelings that you feel involved. You know what I'm saying? Nobody forced Tony not to talk on the show or anything like that. He's talking about how he flew out Gilly the Kid and Gilly the Kid's wife and Waldo and everybody to Mexico. Nobody forced him to do it, bro. So now you throwing your money around, Tony. First mistake you do. Whether you feeling somebody's vibe and energy, first mistake you did right there. Second of all, you're too emotionally invested, as well you should. You're like me. You a loyal motherfucker. People like us always end up losing. But sometimes we gotta check the mirror. We can't blame the people that we wanna blame, bro. We gotta look at ourselves, bro, because maybe to you, you thought you was this family like Gilly the Kid and Wallow. But maybe the Gilly the Kid and Wallow, you was just the nigga that they cool with, but not the nigga that I'm about to share family secrets with, I'm about to break so much breads with, or use my platform to do X, Y, and Z, because we got an entertainment business to do here. We can't stop out and do a BLM service announcement, no disrespect to nobody, because YouTube don't really play like that. Your views will drop if you speak up for this and that. Bro, that's just facts, bro. So you got to think internally like business, Tony. And now let me fast forward. You said you brought the money, you brought exclusive interviews to them. Cool with you. What I've noticed is you're just emotional right now. It ain't nothing. That don't mean Tony is wrong, and it doesn't vindicate Wallow and Gilly if they did do something behind the scenes. I'm just giving y'all, I've been through situations like this. Business, friendship, all that. Tony keeps going into more of personal things instead of what actually that Gilly the Kid and Wallow did to him. That's what's telling you what's in the book, bruh. He's going into how, you know what I'm saying? This dude, him 500, they tried him for him 500. They're using him more. Now I'm like, oh, bro, is it that you a little bit jealous of him 500, Tony? Or a little bit of you thought your friendship was more than what you thought it was. So when you see them being cool with another motherfucker, you start feeling some type of way. We all been guilty of that. We see bro and them we cool with, and then we see this other dude come way out yonder. He cool with bro now. And bro and them giving more time to dude over there, AKA him 500. So niggas is gonna start flexing through their personal feelings. They're gonna wait till something bad that happens to them to finally unleash what they've really been holding up inside for a good goddamn minute now, bruh. Niggas is gonna wait to tell you what they really been feeling for a good goddamn minute, bruh. That ain't nothing but facts, bruh. Nigga, that ain't nothing but the cold hard truth, bruh. Niggas be hopping out the woodwork when it's the right perfect time. And you could tell Tony been feeling these feelings for a minute, because if I'm breaking bread with a nigga, thousands, $100 here, we go to breakfast or something, nigga won't even pick up the tab on a $10 orange juice, on a $20 bacon and cheese breakfast. Niggas won't even pick up the tab. You gotta look at little subtle signs like that. It doesn't mean that Gilly the Kid and Wallow are fake because they don't pick up the whole tab or do certain things you want them to do. It just mean maybe there's a barrier that's there that exists that nobody know that you knew, Tony. Like, niggas can't read minds every day. You can't fault a nigga when he's on a mission of building right now. He can't stop for everybody who got their hands out or their mouth open to be fed, because you kept mentioning they didn't talk about you getting your ass whooped by the cops. You kept mentioning all this extra about what they got going on behind this. Bro, you did a little too much, Tony. And it's not that Gilly the Kid and why I'm not sticking up for them at all. I paid attention to you. You know what I'm saying? That's what I gotta go off. The messenger, the person that's giving me the message, I gotta look at you. And one thing about you, you don't have character flaws as far as being a fake friend or anything like that. Your only flaw is you're too solid. You too built up in a foundation that doesn't exist. The streets is a myth. Loyalty is a myth. Believe me, gang. I done got scars and all type of trepidations I've been through my life because of this loyalty situation. We fought trap and victim into it. And just because another dude ain't loyal to you how you loyal to them, it don't mean all the time they fakes and snakes. Maybe y'all relationship ain't what you thought it was. And sometimes that's the toughest thing for us to get through, when we realize, damn, my relationship with this motherfucker over here ain't what I fucking thought it was, gang. And that can destroy certain people who's not ready to handle and combat that type of situation. You go through it a lot, you get kind of strong ill word. Like, I go through it a lot, so I'm used to it. Been through different cold holes, different friends, family members. But Tony seemed like a guy that gravitates around people who think like him, energy is like him. And I think that's where lies the problem. You went around other motherfuckers who don't have your same mindset. Not saying that Wallow and Gilly the Kid aren't good people, but When you don't have the same mindset with somebody, you're going to clash at times and times. And there's nothing wrong being cool with somebody who may not have the strongest loyalty like you. It don't mean they're going to snake you. It just means they're not going to go out their way to do X, Y, and Z. So you need to keep the relationship established as a business relationship. Big facts. We can't get on the camera for every time we feel an emotional way about something. That's the problem of us, gang. Niggas can't hop on this hoe and talking about, oh, niggas done did me wrong. Niggas done went left, right, right, left. Like, come on, bro. Like, it's doing too much, bro. It reminds, and this is no disrespect to Tony, but it does remind me a case in point with baby mama dramas, bro. To see baby mama always talking bad about your names and this and that, but on another day, they cool. It's like an emotional roller coaster, gang. We can't be going through this. And Tony, you a good dude. I promise you I ain't coming at you, gang, but it's so easy to keep saying Gilly the Kid is a fake dude. It's so easy to, Wallow lied. But one thing I noticed, all you motherfuckers who call Gilly the Kid out, y'all keep mentioning how Wallow is the one who hurt y'all the most, meaning that Wallow obviously got connection with you guys. A man do 20 years locked up, he's gonna speak his real piece to you guys. So obviously the conversation should have been kept in-house. But when you drinking or... sometimes you don't even fucking got a drink, y'all. You feeling the emotional mode right now? You gonna go in, bruh. You gonna go in. And today was the day that Tony felt some type of way, cause he started violating him 500 or whatever. And I feel like I don't even know him 500. Him 500 could be a shaky type dude, bruh. I don't know these niggas from a can of paint. He could be the fakest dude in the world, a snake and all that. But at the end of the day, for you to mention that brother's name, it ain't really how he can't control your emotions and how you work with Gilly and Wallow. It ain't got nothing to do with him if they maybe favor him 500 more. Like, that's like you getting mad at the ex new boyfriend or something like that. Or if you the girl, you getting mad at her. At his new girlfriend. You know what I'm saying? Vice versa, whatever. It's uncomfortable, bro. You don't want to see the person you left happy all the time. That's bullshit. Oh, I just want to see you happy. We're not together no more. Nigga, that's bullshit, bro. Because eventually, it's going to be one of them days you're going to be tweaking out here. You're going to be in your feelings. You're going to look at the old pictures. You're going to be like, that was us, man. That was us, man. It was us fucking doing this thing. And now you see this new face. You're going to feel some type of way, not just for the people who left you for the new face, but you're going to feel some type of way for the new face. All this is natural. All this is normal. Honestly, I feel like Tony kind of hurt his relationship with Gilly the Kid and Wallow because they now know you a motherfucker that runs to the internet. It's not that they're going to hate you, jump you, or anything like that, but I'm pretty sure they're going to give a conversation with you. But I think it's best for right now y'all stay away from each other and you get off that camera. You got energy, Tony. Get your tail on this wave of media platform, bro. Ain't you been learning anything from Gilly the Kid and Wallow? That's another thing about you dudes. Like, y'all like complaining a whole lot, but did you learn game? $1 million worth of game, no pun intended. They really is teaching game over here without even uttering their mouth, bro. You should have been more observant, and you probably was, but get started with your brand. Your brand is already growing bigger. This probably amplifies it more, nigga. All you gotta do right now is stay focused on you, bro. Get out your feelings, bro. Trust me, I've been there. That feeling could get all of us hypnotized, bruh. Got us tweaking the fuck out, doing shit we don't even want to be doing out here. You hear me? You hear me, bruh? Like, I'm about to leave right now, man. But I hope Tony, Gilly the Kid, and Wallow, and even him 500, everybody could breach their peace. But in life, it don't work like that, bruh. We go our separate ways every fucking day. Niggas will be all right, gang. Niggas will fucking be all right, man. I'm your God bless one, man. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. Y'all do me a favor right quick, man. I'm combating this YouTube algorithm. Just do a nigga fit. Like, niggas don't even be donating our own bitch and complain about it. But give me a like, bro. That's all I'm asking, bro. I don't be tweaking. Give me a fucking like button right quick, man. Salute to the game, man. And I'm out in this piece, man. This your God bless one. Thank you for watching another episode of I Smoke Hip Hop Live. Salute. We out in this piece, man.